We are in the final stages of the preparation of Evernote V11. We originally wanted to target November 11th, just because, you know, 11/11 looked nice. But we are working on embeddings. We want Evernote V11 to be your ultimate productivity partner. And that means that it needs to understand what your notes are about. So not just storing the characters and the words that compose your notes, but actually like understand their meaning. Turning notes and content, written content from a format of text to a format of meaning is a process that is called embedding. That is basically what we are doing now. So we are preparing embeddings, which are a way to represent words and concepts into vectors. So into basically meaning that natural language processing tech can understand. This means in practice that we are currently indexing 3.2 billion notes, and this is just for users that were active in the past 2 months. So we are taking all their notes and we are indexing them, and we are preparing them essentially for Evernote V11. This is an incredible number, and we can't wait for it to be done so that we can finally all experience AI assistant and semantic search, which are just two of the major features that we are shipping with Evernote V11. Of course, Evernote still treats all of your content, both your notes as usual, but including embeddings, as private and confidential. So the same level of data safety that you've been used to when storing your content on Evernote is still guaranteed, and the process of generating the embeddings happens internally. In the meantime, we have released a preview of AI Assistant to select paying customers already in V10, just so that we can gather some feedback from them and we can tweak the final feature. And this is what V11 is going to include. So it's going to include AI Assistant, which I'm going to show you in a second. It's going to include meeting notes, which is an evolution of AI Transcribe. It's also finally going to include semantic search, which is a very powerful transformation of how search works on Evernote. Plus, there is a new insert menu, which is already available for all paying customers in V10. There is a new slash command menu, again. We built it last year, and then we wanted to make it even more powerful. So that's also going to be included in V11, and it's already available in preview for paying customers on V10. And there's a new citation generator. So let's start from citation generator. This is available for everybody. It's on the web. With citation generator, I can just go and write The Great Gatsby and choose the language, and it will find matches for books in this case, and will generate the citations in the right format. Or I can switch to articles and I can look for stuff like GLP-1, and it will find citations to articles that mention, in this case, glucagon-like peptides. And so it's very powerful for you when you need to do some research. Let's take a look at the first feature that is going to land on Evernote V11. It's called AI Assistant, and it works like this. So I have my family recipes notebook here and my top brownies recipe open in this note. So let me trigger the new AI Assistant. As you see, its UI is a chat, and I can ask anything. For instance, in this case, I'm going to ask, what could go well with this recipe? Grandma is lactose intolerant. And I'm going to click web search because I wanted to actually look for something that could go well with this recipe. Okay, I searched the web and it's suggesting lactose-free desserts like dairy-free vanilla ice cream, fresh berries, chopped or toasted nuts and dried fruit, and other stuff. I can also ask, convert the ingredients in this recipe to a shopping list. I don't need salt or baking powder. And here it is. Now, of course, you don't need to start a new chat every time you want to interact with it. So for instance, in this case, I can ask it, add fresh berries to the list. Okay, so it added fresh berries to the list. And with this button, I can just create a new note. Brownie ingredients update. And there we have it. Now let's take a look at the new slash commands. So I have this meeting notes from Project Apollo, and I can just write header. I want a small header. I want to make it green. So I can just type slash green and I can call these action items. Now all of these I can select, and I'm going to show you the new insert menu. In the new insert menu, I can search. I want to turn these into tasks, so I have new task, and I can also favorite. So if this is an action that I do frequently, I can save it as favorite, so it's going to appear at the top of the list next time. I can click task, and it just turned my 7 action items into tasks. Let's also take a look at how semantic search works on Evernote V11. So search is as powerful as ever on Evernote, and probably the oldest feature request for Evernote has been the ability to search in notes based on meaning and not based on just like keywords. What does this mean in practice? Let me show you. So let's look for Barcelona trip. When I look for Barcelona trip, usually the standard search would look for Barcelona trip or both inside my notes and notebooks and propose a list of things that I might want to check out, ranked by how relevant it thinks the match of the two keywords to be compared to the list that it found. Now, there's this new section here called Smart Results, where you see that none of the notes actually has in the title, and you can't see it, but it's not even in the body of the note, there is neither Barcelona nor trip. They're all called Girona Weekend Plan or Spanish Restaurants or Valencia Beach Retreat. So these, even though these don't contain Barcelona or trip, they're still shown over there. Similarly, if I look for Barcelona ticket number, I will see this section called Quick Answer, which is going to extract the single nugget of information that it thinks is what I want to know, and it's going to tell me the actual number of my ticket. And of course, when I expand here, I can check the sources, like in this case, Barcelona confirmations. The same thing happens when I actually press enter and I actually run my search. So Barcelona ticket number, I will get my quick answer here, and I will still get the full list of results under there. And again, I can check that the quick answer is based on the right note. Next, let's take a look at meeting notes. You can press insert. You will see this new badge here close to audio recording, and it will ask you if it's an in-person meeting or if it's a remote meeting. If it's an in-person meeting, it will use your external microphone. If it's remote, it will use both your external microphone to record your voice and the internal one basically to record the audio that that is coming from your computer, so from people that are connected remotely. Let's try remote in this case. Of course, it's going to tell you explicitly that the audio is going to be processed to generate a transcript. And now we're recording. Now let's pretend that our meeting is over. And here is our recording for our brainstorming session. So I can transcribe and summarize immediately, but I can also, if I want, turn off individually summary, transcript, and speaker recognition. So in this case, I don't need a summary. I just need a transcript, and let's transcribe the meeting. It's going to process it for a while. It is going to tell me, to give me the list of sentences, basically. Now, of course, it doesn't recognize who these people are, but I know, and I can just say that this is Sarah, and this is John. And of course, Meeting Notes knows that this is Sarah and this is John, so as you can see, it will replace Sarah every time it hears Sarah speak. Lastly, I now changed my mind and I actually wanted a summary of this meeting, so I will click this summary button here and it will also generate a summary here. And this is everything that is going to be included in Evernote V11. Well, not everything, everything. There are still a few more things that we haven't mentioned, but I'll leave you the joy of discovering those. Thank you for waiting. We are really putting our hearts and souls into making Evernote V11 the best it can be. And we truly hope you will find it useful, most of all, and exciting to work with. Thank you all, and I'll see you soon.